I was inside when he came to the door. When I came to the door, he was outside.
It wasn't just the ring of a doorbell after 11 o'clock Sunday night that seemed suspicious to this homeowner. It was the person on the other side asking for someone who didn't live there.
Jeff, there's no Jeff here. Jeff don't live here. And then he turned around and he walked away. And I had flicked the light on.
This homeowner thought the situation seemed strange, so he went outside to investigate and quickly spotted three people.
I went out there and I said, man, these guys are definitely up to something. So I stood there in the middle of the sidewalk. And so I says, well, let me check my truck real quick while they're walking south. I had walked over here to my truck to see if it was locked. And when I hit it, it was locked, so it popped. And when I popped it and it made that noise, I turned around and one of them boys said, he's running.
But this homeowner wasn't running at all.
I was still standing still, so it sounded like it was my cue to start running. Because they were coming back after me, and I seen them running towards me, and I took off running as fast as I could back in the house. I got three steps into my hallway, and gunshots were fired.
But this is what was left behind, bullet holes and now a lot of fear.
The feeling inside you is the worst because, you know, you feel like you can't trust anybody.
Investigators think the suspects wanted inside the house and say he did the right thing by not answering the door. A message this victim wants everyone to hear.
Just call 911. Just do that. Don't try to be a hero, you know, because it's not worth it.
Well, you're looking here at the Highland Clubhouse in this area. A K-9 was called in, and they were able to track a scent to this clubhouse, which is just probably 200 yards away from where this all happened. They think they probably had a getaway car here. No arrests have been made. If you have any information, you're asked to call the sheriff's office. We're live in Vero Beach, Erin Guy, WPBF 25 News.